Hello, YouTube. I recently installed a new cold air intake in my Jeep, many of which you have seen in action, or many of you, I should say. It's a Specter Performance cold air intake designed for Jeep Cherokees. I have a 2001 Cherokee myself. The Specter Performance cold air intake cost me about $145. I would say comparable, if not slightly better, than the K&N $350 cold air intake I had on previous. Here comes a Jeep person. I don't know if you'll be able to see them on the video. We're going to give them a wave, and they wave back. Very nice. Hang on, I don't know if you can see, but way up yonder, there's quite the police commotion, so I'm actually going to lower this, and you're just going to stare at my clock for a little bit here as I continue to talk about the Specter Performance cold air intake. It is a mostly metal design, a few plastic parts. It has steel braided hose that comes with it for the functionality of your breather tube. Oh, looks like they're redirecting traffic. I'm gonna have to split this up. One of those really awesome moments as you go through a police blockade after, I guess they look like a three-car pileup, and three of the police officers directing traffic gave me a thumbs up in my Jeep, which for the record is very illegal as far as height regulations, noise regulations. I, you know, don't have a mirror. I don't have a bumper. It's absurd. Anyways, so Specter Performance cold air intake continued here. My interest in making this video is that I read a lot of reviews online. I read a lot about how noisy it is. I don't know if you can hear though, on light acceleration, you get a hissing as it has the throttle body open part way. Now the design of it, instead of pulling the air from the engine bay above the driver's side front wheel, it actually pulls the air from just forward of the windshield wipers. It requires a 3-inch hole drilled in your firewall. Not too difficult, just go to a local home improvement store, pick up some metal rated 3-inch hole saw and attach it to your drill. Aside from that, a lot of people were commenting on the massive amounts of noise it creates while you drive. I don't find it to be too tedious. The hissing is kind of obnoxious because people keep asking what the hell is wrong with your car, but really it's nothing. And as soon as you hit the throttle, it's got a really nice throaty sound to it. And as soon as we pass this little speed trap over here, we are going to take it up a notch and see if we can get you to hear the sound of the cold air intake. Looks like we're coming up to a stoplight, but it just turned green. So this looks like a perfect chance for us to have some fun. See if we can give them some space up there. Watch the RPMs and listen to it. Here we go. And there's another officer right there. Uh-oh. Did I irritate him? We're gonna find out. At any rate, relatively nice design. I think it looks better, and it might perform even a little bit better, if not just about equivalent to the $349 K&N version for the Jeep Cherokee. I give this one probably a 9 out of 10. The installation is definitely not advanced by any means. If you've used a drill before and you've attached a cold air intake before, or anything under the hood for that matter, it's pretty straightforward. Comes with instructions on what to do and where to do it. Quite a bit of fun. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hope the video was helpful. Towards the end here, I'm going to make one more once I park so I can show you what it looks like underneath the hood. Thank you very much, YouTube. Rate, comment, give me lots of thumbs up, stuff like that. And I will have more videos for you soon. Well. I went over the video footage briefly, only to find out you really didn't get a good feel of what it sounded like whilst under heavy acceleration. And so that's what we are here to do. I didn't want to remake the entire video, so we are just going to add this portion to it as I do some heavy acceleration, and hopefully you can capture the idea of what it sounds like here. So that was about 30 miles an hour to just about 50 miles an hour. I'm on my way to the auto parts store to pick up something for my other vehicle, and at which time I will gladly, there's some people looking at me as we stop at the stoplight, probably fucking angry that I'm taking videos of them. Hello. Oh, okay. What was I saying? Sorry, I got distracted. Right, gonna show you a quick look in the engine bay so you can see what the Specter Performance cold air intake looks like. Definitely worth the money, as I've driven it for about 2 weeks now. I've been driving, really no difference in gas mileage, but then again, we're driving a Cherokee. It's not your run-of-the-mills Honda Civic here. This is by no means the vehicle that you want to drive if you're looking to save gas. But anyways, don't forget to subscribe, rate, and comment so I can continue doing this. Thank you, YouTube. All right, well, welcome to my garage, YouTube. Like I said, I'm going to be showing you the inside of the engine bay here and what that Specter Performance cold air intake looks like. So this being obviously a very muddy engine bay, if you can even see it with the angle of light. Something that I guess I should mention as far as insulation goes is if you don't already see it, you're gonna have to remove your engine bay light for this to fit in properly. Basically, there's only one spot that you can actually fit it, but definitely set it all up. Don't tighten anything down, just so you can figure out exactly where your hole's gonna go. For me, I guess, like an idiot, eager to put this in, I put the hole just a little bit too high, so I had to seal it off in here with just some high heat sealant. You can probably do it with any high heat, that's the word I'm looking for, not caulk, but silicone sealant would be fine. Like I said, this is all metal. Plastic parts are, let's see here, what are the plastic parts? I believe this is actually plastic, although it may not be. Very few plastic parts. Oh, I believe these are some form of crappy metal or plastic. Like I said, you got your steel rated hose. Aside from that though, I mean, like I said, it comes with everything you need except for the screwdriver and the drill and the hole saw. Like I said, 3-inch. You can only really do it once, so don't mess up. My mess up was minor. I'm really not too upset about it. Leaves you with this really large gap. I used to have a PA system with a speaker in here, and I'm gonna relocate it so the speaker's right here. Another thing is if you're mudding, if you're into bombing puddles or anything of that nature, without your splash shield in there, you actually end up with a lot of water getting, or just moisture in general, getting sucked up into your air intake if you have just a K&N. The stock one, obviously, probably protects it quite a bit more than the K&N one does, but this is phenomenal because, let's see if I can close this hood while I take a video without killing myself. That'd be nice. I'm gonna stare at my wall over there for a second. With this air intake, if you have a Cherokee, you'll notice from about here to about here, there is airflow. It's for your cabin. And over here is all solid. So this being where the air comes in, to the colder intake, and over there is where the air comes into the that little firewall area, protects the engine from vapor lock and any moisture getting in. It's a really nice setup. Like I said, I would highly recommend it. Little shout out to Grand Theft Auto there. But thank you for viewing, YouTube. Enjoy.